Recognize as well that a physical fast will change the energies of your emotions based upon how the brain distorts that which you perceive to be yourself. Food does not directly change our emotions. Rather, food changes the chemicals within our body, the chemicals within our brain, and also the vibration of the cells. This then reflects change into the emotional body. But food itself does not change your emotions. It will change your physical body. Now, dear ones, you can add to this practice as well as a mental fast. And so when you isolate and remove food, when you isolate and remove social environment interactions, you also must isolate and remove knowledge. You must not read. You must not try to learn anything new. During this period of isolation, you are allowing your mind to come back to yourself. Instead of putting other people's ideas into your mind through learning, instead of distracting your mind through books or other activities, you are just being with your mind. And so a true fast for mind, body, and emotion is one in which you isolate yourself in nature, away from other people, away from books and televisions and information, away from sources of food. And you simply be with yourself, watching, observing, feeling what happens within you. This is the exact self-study that we recommend for those who are most brave, for those who are most mature, and most intelligent. Understand why we place these restrictions. If you have not fasted before, do not isolate yourself. Do not be prepared to fast alone on your own unless you feel confident knowing what a fast is like, unless you know how to care for yourself during a fast. Do not isolate yourself from others for long periods of time until you know the content of that which is in your emotional body. You can do a weekend fast or a week-long fast emotionally, but do not plan for longer periods of time until you are already comfortable with that which arises within you when you are all alone without distraction. Likewise, for a mental fast, do not remove all stimulating mental content until you are comfortable with what is operating in your mind, until you are familiar with it. The reason why we place these restrictions is this. Most people spend the majority of their lives avoiding that which they have within them. Most people are unaware of the depth of their own emotional pain, suffering, human conditionings, and karma. Most people are not prepared for that which is within them, for them to see that which is within them. It is very strong, and that is why the subconscious mind has repressed certain things, and that is why the subconscious mind is projecting certain addictive patterns, because they form as a distraction to keep you safe from that which is within you. But for those who are ready, for those who want to move beyond limitation, for those who desire truth more than anything else, then, dear ones, then you can work towards greater things. We would like to add to this as well. Some of you may have extreme forms of emotional and mental illness, but you, dear ones, may not be aware of them. It is important to observe yourself to understand what's operating within you so that you are prepared for it. Do not isolate yourselves until you are ready, until you know that your safety is assured. For some of you, due to your mental illness, whether big or small, may choose to starve yourself instead of fast. You may go beyond the period of time when your body tells you you must stop. Some of you may be destroyed psychologically by looking at everything within your mind. The pain may be too great to do it all at once, so work slowly. Work with the methods that we have provided, those based on divine love. For as we have said during this channeling, love, the good human experiences, is that which heals and unites. It unites the fractures within our energy system. It removes the karmas from our body. Heal with love and work at it. Eventually, you will know when you want to do a type of emotional fast. You will know when you want to dedicate an entire weekend to doing karmic healing, chakra healing, divine love and spiritual heart meditations. There is nothing wrong with giving yourself time to do this, and we recommend that you do in fact honor yourself and your spiritual path with periodic states of isolation. But do it within reason. Do not endanger your own health or your own harm. You may ask a friend to check in on you, but do not communicate in social conversation. Your friend can check in each and every day, just to make sure you are doing well. If you pick a friend to do this, make sure that they understand clearly what you are doing, so they will not be afraid, because their fear can create distortions in their perception, and they can project their fear upon what is happening within you. Now, dear ones, we will end our message today with this. Every person at their divine center is that of love. We are this. When you find the light within your heart, it will heal all karmas. When you stay as this light in your daily life, it will purify the karmas of mind, body, and emotion. And you will begin to perceive reality more clearly. Our ego projects itself into this light and creates distortions in what we perceive to be reality. It creates distortions in how we change our expressions into life. Stay as this center, this consciousness of light that is love, unconditional, unchanging love. Stay here. And live from this place, and you will gain knowledge, and you will gain love. Your suffering will be removed. We know no greater power than that of divine love. Embrace it. Be it. With a silent mind and an open heart, be the love that you are. Be the source of life. Many blessings, dear ones. Much love. Namaste.